Most people have no idea that these projects are ongoing behind the scenes. I'm Vicki Ozaki. I'm a geologist at Redwood National State Parks, and I'm the project manager for the Redwoods Rising Aquatic Restoration. So what we're looking at here is large wood that we have installed in the stream to really kind of kickstart stream channel processes that have been missing for a long time. The channel prior to any wood was just kind of a flat bowling alley look. There was not a lot of complexity. The volume of wood in this reach is much less than the old growth sections. There's 2.5 times more volume of large wood upstream in an undisturbed stream setting. Places where adult salmon can tuck behind as they're coming into the creek. So the Park Service wants to nudge these channels to perform more naturally. We identified that we would put 50 large trees in the creek. So by putting wood in, we're hoping to scour some pools and create more habitat for fish. We worked with the Yurok tribe to do this project, and I think this is some of the biggest wood they've ever worked with. Well, they're experts in stream restoration, and they are well regarded for their expertise and their abilities. And I think, you know, working with them on this project is very apparent how well they know these systems and really how to place wood. It was very amazing, really, to watch them at work. Very efficient. I think what's really remarkable, too, is to work with the Yurok tribe to work on these stream restoration projects within their ancestral territory. So there's a lot of benefits to have the wood in here, and also the channel has been in the same place for a long time. It's missing this element of wood that helps the channel migrate and move around. Let's get this thing moving and messy.
There you go, there you go.
So imagine loading these things in, 50 pieces of these being tucked into this channel. It's really a significant difference for how this channel will evolve in the future.